Joe Biden's highly anticipated first address to the nation since dropping out of the presidential race was a flop. Social media is in overdrive with commentators slamming the president, who stumbled and mumbled his way through the prepared speech. Despite reading from a teleprompter in the Oval Office with no press surrounding him, Joe Biden still struggled to form coherent sentences.
The truth, the sacred cause of this country, is larger than any one of us. And those of us who cherish that cause cherish it so much. A cause of American democracy itself must unite to protect it.
Many also commented on his orange-looking appearance, with the president seemingly coated in very heavy makeup to make him appear healthier.
My fellow Americans.
But he wasn't fooling anyone, with commentators saying Biden looked very frail and off. And from the outset, Joe Biden made humiliating error after error.
Ben Franklin was asked, as he emerged from the convention going on, whether the founders have given America a monarchy or a republic. Franklin's response was, a republic, if you can keep it.
And again,
when you make that choice, remember the words of Benjamin Franklin's hanging on my wall here in the Oval Office, alongside the bust of Dr. King and Rosa Parks and Cesar Chavez. When Ben Franklin was asked, as he emerged from the convention going on, whether the founders had given America a monarchy or a republic, Franklin's response was, a republic. If you can keep it. A republic, if you can keep it.
And the teleprompter won again.
We've come so far since my inauguration. On that day, I told you, as I stood in that winter, we were stood in a winter of peril and a winter of possibilities. Peril and possibilities.
Many were expecting the president to outline his reasons as to why he is dropping out of the race and provide insight into his health battles. But he did none of that, instead saying he's withdrawing to pass the torch on to the next generation.
My leadership in the world, my vision for America's future, all merited a second term. But nothing, nothing can come in the way of saving our democracy. That includes personal ambition. So I've decided the best way forward is to pass the torch to a new generation. That's the best way to unite our nation. You know, there is a time and a place for long years of experience in public life. But there's also a time and a place for new voices, fresh voices, yes, younger voices. And that time and place is now.
He said he believes he deserves a second term, but is putting saving America's democracy first.
When you elected me to this office, I promised to always level with you, to tell you the truth. And the truth, the sacred cause of this country is larger than any one of us. And those of us who cherish that cause cherish it so much, a cause of American democracy itself. Must unite to protect it. You know, in recent weeks, it's become clear to me that I need to unite my party in this critical endeavor. I believe my record as president, my leadership in the world, my vision for America's future, all merited a second term. But nothing, nothing can come in the way of saving our democracy. That includes personal ambition. So I've decided the best way forward is to pass the torch to a new generation. It's the best way to unite our nation. You know, there is a time and a place for long years of experience in public life. There's also a time and a place for new voices, fresh voices, yes, younger voices. And that time and place is now.
Joe Biden was also blasted for gaslighting the nation, saying the US is not in any wars anywhere in the world. Commentators clapped back, highlighting the US is in several proxy wars.
You know, I will keep working to ensure America remains strong secure and the leader of the free world. I'm the first president in this century to report to the American people that the United States is not at war anywhere in the world. We'll keep rallying a coalition of proud nations to stop Putin from taking over Ukraine, doing more damage. We'll keep NATO stronger, and I'll make it more powerful and more united than any time in all of our history. I'll keep doing the same for our allies in the Pacific.
And in another lie, Joe Biden tried to spin his horrendous record on illegal immigration.
The crime rate is at a 50-year low. We're also securing our border. Border crossings are lower today than when the previous administration left office. I've kept my commitment to appoint the first black woman to the Supreme Court of the United States of America.
Commentators on X launched on this lie, slamming the president for insulting the intelligence of the American people. The president also boasted about improving the economy during his term.
Today we have the strongest economy in the world, creating nearly 16 million new jobs, a record. Wages are up. Inflation continues to come down.
But commentators slammed this as a complete lie, as many Americans battle with the cost of living crisis.